Bitch, I be ball like an athlete. Make a nigga run like he had a track meet. I'ma make sure the whole squad eat. 50 bands stacked up in the backseat. Connect with your bitch like Wi-Fi. But it's a brick, now they call me the bad guy. Take a nigga up. What's going on, YouTube? This your boy Scat Pack J back with another video. And in this video, I will be installing my rear diffuser, my carbon fiber looking rear diffuser. It's not real carbon fiber, it's carbon fiber look. As you can see there, you can really tell on the back, you know, it's just plastic. But anyway, before we get into it, I want y'all to like, comment, subscribe, hit that bell notification so you're updated anytime I upload any videos. And without further ado, let's get into it. And so first things first, we gotta take off this old one. And I believe it's a few screws just up under here that I gotta disattach first. As you can see, the car is kind of dirty because it's been sitting overnight and I've been driving it and I haven't really washed it, but yeah, we're gonna have to keep some of the, keep the old hardware so that I can mount the new rear diffuser up. Yeah, everything should fit, you know, everything looked like it matched up. But I ordered this off of Amazon. It cost me about $150. It was another one that I wanted that was a gloss black, but I think the carbon fiber looked, you know, a whole lot better. And I will leave a link in the description below in case any of y'all are looking to get yourself one that has a Scat Pack or maybe a Hellcat. But yeah, and when I ordered it, it said that it doesn't fit this vehicle, but I knew it did. You know, I don't know, Amazon, I guess they ain't got their stuff right, you know, when it comes to matching up, you know, your vehicle and all that good stuff. But you know, I checked with the company and everything, you know, everything looks like it matched up. So we're gonna go ahead and get it installed. So first I'm gonna take this old one off. I'm gonna sit the camera down. I got a few tools I need. I'm gonna have to use to do it. I'm gonna probably fast forward this part, so here we go. Alright, just so y'all know, that's gonna be installing a rear diffuser that uses these little push pin type things yourself. Make sure you take them out very carefully because you don't want to break them. Because you're gonna need those to, you know, use it for the new one when you put it back in. So just be careful of that. So I got one out, I'm finna take the next one out. So y'all give me a second. The next clip would be me actually going to install the new rear diffuser. So here we go. All right, so we got all the pins and everything out. So it's time to pluck this old one out. And just looking at the new one that I'm be putting in, it looks like it's quite a few little tabs that's gonna have to be popped out. So I'll try my best to be careful in popping these out. So I'm gonna just give y'all a little, you know, a time lapse of me taking this part off. So y'all just give me a second. All right, y'all, so I'm running into some issues. I realized the car is a little too low for me to get up under, try to get those clamps out that's holding this rear diffuser to this bumper. So I'm gonna show y'all what I'm looking at. So up inside there, I don't know if y'all can see it. I'm trying to get y'all a good view of it. But yeah, I don't know if you can see right there. Well, anyway, these clamps are holding this rear diffuser in. You might be able to see it kind of lined up right up in there. But sorry if you can't see, I don't have a flashlight with me, but I'm gonna have to somehow pop those clamps off, you know, from the inside just to get this rear diffuser out. It was very difficult trying to do it with the car leveled, so I had to put the car on my ramps. And don't worry, these ramps are strong enough to hold this car up, and I use it for my SUV as well. So
I'm gonna go ahead and try to pop these off, but I don't want to bore y'all too much with the installation. So once I get this old rear diffuser off, yeah, you probably see it better now. You probably see right there where my finger at, those little clamps. I don't want to bore y'all with the installation, so once I get this off, then I turn back on the camera. All right, so I finally got it off. Took a little while, took longer than I expected, but we made it do what it do. So now the only thing is to put the new one on. This one should be fairly easy. And just gotta slide those little clamp things back in the old slot. This thing pretty dirty too. I don't know, I might wipe this off before I throw it back on, or really it wouldn't even matter. But anyway, I'll throw this new one back on, then I'll get back with y'all. Just a little side note here. These little clamps you see right there, the little silver one. Now, when you go back to install the new rear diffuser, these little screws are gonna screw up into there from the bottom right here. So just make sure, you know, when you're taking off the old rear diffuser, those are back lined up. So I just pushed them back in place because they were kind of crooked. You got four of them. You got that one, two in the middle, and then you got one on the side right there, as you can see right there. But just kind of push them back in place so that way you won't have no trouble, you know, screwing them back in once you get the new rear diffuser on. So I don't know if, you know, some of y'all may know that, but just kind of something I kind of picked up on before I got ready to put this new one back on. So I'm gonna set the camera up and I'm gonna show y'all me putting it back on. So here we go. Alright, finally got it on. It's a little trouble, but I made it do what it do like I always do. So what y'all think about that? And like I said before, this is not real carbon fiber, this is a carbon fiber look. You got everything mounted up, looking good, holes lined up. I get it, I'll put back together and I'll show y'all finished look once I get everything, once I get the car back on the ground. Put on, looks good with that wicker bill now.
slowly but surely this car is coming together. I hope y'all enjoyed it. What y'all think about it? What'd you think about the cake?
Good.
Okay. Took you a while. But it's not like it. But yeah. There y'all go. Like I was saying before, you know, just make sure you be careful taking off the
close that door.
Just make sure you be careful taking off the old one. You know, you don't want to snap those little pins. Well, it wouldn't matter if you're taking it off, but when you go to put on the new one, I'm gonna show y'all something real quick. I'm gonna use the old one as an example. Now, when you get ready to put the new one on, what I had to do, these right here, you're gonna have to kind of bend them up a little bit because it is a piece that's on the bumper. It's a little piece that's gonna actually stop those from kind of going in. So what I did was I just bent these up, you know, and I was able to, you know, put the new one on a lot easier. And you know, it's gonna hook right there once it gets in the bumper anyway. So it's not gonna do any damage if you were to hook it up, cause it's gonna grab on from the top anyway, holding it in. And just make sure you don't lose your screws that came off the old one, because, you know, well, the one I got didn't come with any new hardware. So I had to use the old hardware. And you got four screws right here. And then these on the end, those are not screws, you know, coming off of the car. Those are like a little push pin, so when you're taking them out, just be careful not to snap those, otherwise you'll be heading to the auto parts store to get you, you know, some new ones. And, you know, why get some new ones when you can use the old ones? But yeah, looks pretty good. Let me know what y'all think in the comments, you know. And I also leave a link in the description, you know, if you want to order this exact, you know, rear diffuser. But you know, Amazon pretty much got everything, you know, from all different types of car companies, where you can order a diffuser, you can do gloss black, carbon fiber look, or you can even order a real carbon fiber. So I just went with this one. I was hesitant about ordering the, you know, this rear diffuser, because I actually want to do dual tips instead of just having a, you know, a single tip, you know, rear diffuser. But, you know, I think this looks pretty good. But I'm definitely gonna be getting some bigger, oh, excuse me, y'all, it's cold out here, my nose running. I'm definitely gonna be getting some bigger, you know, exhaust tips. I'm gonna go with the 5-inch, and I'm gonna probably bring them out a little bit more. Probably kind of bring them out, you know, kind of, you know, even with the rear diffuser. I think that'll look good. So, but anyway, y'all let me know in the comment what y'all think, you know. Pretty simple installation, you know, nothing too hard. You know, I didn't have to cut nothing or anything like that, but pretty much straightforward, you know. But anyway, that's it with this video. I do appreciate y'all tuning in and watching the video. Hopefully y'all don't see my boogers running out my nose. My nose is running, but anyway, like, comment, subscribe, hit the bell notification so you're updated anytime I upload any new videos. Without further ado, and I'll see y'all next week. Peace.